And welcome to this Alkalinux B system. Plasma has widgets, and even though that these widgets are present and we'll cover them in future tutorials, people would like to have the conkeys that they're used to on XFCE or OpenBox, Awesome, etc. Right? They would like to see the conkey, and there is a conkey Xen, and it is already installed on the ISO, so nothing to do. The only thing you do is run it. So the Alkalinux conkey manager comes up. I click usually on the conkey name, so it's alphabetically, so I can see alphabetically what I will activate. And anything you click up here, you select, and it's going to be active. Now, there is a question about a specific one that will not work, does not work on Plasma. And then I thought maybe I should make it more clear to people that if you install a conkey on a desktop environment, it's never gonna work 100% on all the desktops. And that's why I've created a new subsection down here. General conkey info. So whatever article you're going to look for conkeys, and there's already lots of tutorials about conkeys, so you really should read and follow the videos. So I'm going to take a completely different article, and you'll see at the bottom I've added everywhere this general conkey information. A conkey will never ever work on all desktops. The code that you have will never ever work. Why? Because there are so much differences, too much differences between all the different window managers. XFCE, OpenBox, then we have Mate, we have Cinnamon, we have Plasma, etc. It will depend on the software that you've installed. So people asking questions on Arch Linux, you need to have the software. What kind of software? There are two versions of conkey already. There's a version that's lower, 1.9 and lower, and 1.10 and higher. It means old syntax has new syntax. It has consequences. Then you would like maybe all these things that we've just added here, all these elements here, are actually Lua things. So if you don't install the Konka Lua arches, which we do, standard, and Arch Linux, and Arch Linux Plasma, then you also have problems with these special clocks and dials and everything, right? And I've added, and I will maybe change in the future, add more lines to it, things that are critical to the conkey. So the conkey does not know what kind of desktop environment you're on. And there are possibilities. You can change this file, this variable, the own window type, from desktop to normal, to override, to dock. Just try out. Reload, try, and see if it works. See, stay, see the color is good, see it's transparent or not transparent. All these options are probably going to be in these four lines, or we'll add more in the future. If you want to know more and learn more about conkeys, you can check out this website, of course, but also check out the Arch Wiki or all the official conkey websites here and learn more about conkeys. That being said, we have this beautiful conkey, but once we click on the desktop, it's gone. That's an issue, right? And people say, hey, the conkey doesn't work. No, the conkey works just fine. The problem is the desktop does not fix it, does not recognize, or the conkey is not, well, processed the correct way on this window manager. So how to fix it? That's the thing. Give you the knowledge to fix it. First off, we need to know again, what was it actually? We need to know that name. So just to be sure, it's the WO from Willem, donated by Willem, and it's the Conkey System Lua version 3 that we have on our system. Okay, so that's the one. Let's keep it here so we have the correct one. Once we have it, we can close it. Conkeys are in the .config, are in the conkey, and there's the Willem conkey here. And we need, nope, that's not the one, that's the clock one. The system is the one we need, and Lua version 3, W Conkey System Lua. W conkey system Lua and then version 3. Okay, so that's the one we need. That's the one that we launch. If we launch it again, it's back here. Once we click the desktop, it's gone again. Fine. So we need to get into this file. We open it with Cape since we are on Plasma. Otherwise I would have done Atom or Sublime maybe, but let's keep working on applications that are from Plasma. And here you see that the provider is Willem, right? And if you want to see more about these conkeys, you can check out his DeviantArt URL. The thing is, since we're now on Plasma, he's processing all these elements and he is going to change or use this desktop thing. That's the first thing I would try in if I were in your place and say, let's try to override it. So the own window type is overriding. Okay, save. Now, let's wait for it. If it does not load, let's reload everything. So it's staying black. What I would always suggest you do is go to the Conky Zen and just say okay, because it's going to kill everything, every Conky, and reload every Conky, and that's exactly what we need to have. Now, if I click somewhere, right mouse click, everything is normal. When I click here, it works as well. I can't move it, can't click it. And also important, things that are above it don't get behind it. There's no layer or anything. So it's really now on your desktop, fixed and unmoving. So that's what you need to do from time to time, depending on the desktop you're on, is get inside this code. Now, just reminded something, once we do an update of the conkeys, what you'll do, I've made an article just about that, we're going to update, right? And when we update, this new file, or this file, will be overwritten if we type the command alias. Remember, alias command and then scale. This command here is going to override the etc scale. That's what I meant. I said it wrong, but I meant it right. So scale is actually going to override your conkey that you've built, that you've changed, that now is correct on Plasma. So best thing to do is Control C, Control V, and give it, for instance, your own name, right? Now you know that it's just a copy paste, and the only difference between them is just the override. So once I do a copy, once I do an update of a conkey, and you do type skel, your own conkey will not be overwritten. You changed something, you added something. And this is, I think, the best way to proceed if you are really going to dive into the world of conkeys. Rename the conkey so that after, months and months of working, and you get all these updates in from Arch Linux and you do a skel, then it's not overwritten. So let's activate and see it works as well. Conky Zen, last thing I'm going to do is right mouse click and add to favorites, because it's much too long to get to. So now it's right here, select your conkey. And this is the one that we have, but there's another one now. Let's make it a little bit bigger. Here it is, Eric. So get rid of that one. We're going to use my own one. Okay. There you go. And this is working as well, of course. Why not? It's just copy paste. And maybe we could fake here that there's an update going on. And you do a scale. And if you do a scale, everything is copy pasted over, meaning your code has been written over with the new code. And if we delete this one and get the code, the old code back, so this one is going to break again, right? So best thing to do is rename the conkey that you've changed, and then it will never ever be overwritten. As you see here, select your conkey and then take the Eric one again. Okay. And it works again, right? That's what I want to share about conkeys. There's lots of more to read on the Arch Wiki and or on the links that you can follow here. This is the original GitHub from of 4, Conky, and lots of links here, lots of links to learn about Conkies. All right, have fun and enjoy your Conky.